Very good evening, all the viewers. This is Dharminder Singh. Welcome to in a very special program on CIIT NCERT channel number 31, Swayam Prabha Kishore Manchan. What is special about today to tell you? Because we are going to discuss about NISTA. NISTA is not the topic, NISTA is an institution now, you can say. And what is that? National Initiative for School Heads and Teachers Holistic Advancement. And what is that advancement? I'll tell you a bit more, because this NISTA has been launched in August 2019, and what it has done, you can say now. I'll let you know in brief. They trained, they have completed, they, you know, achieved 17.5 teachers in training. I think that deserve a big round of applause. And then after, what exactly happened? Because everybody knows, due to this ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, we have shifted this face-to-face mode to the online module. And you will be coming to know, you will be happy while listening this, that Andhra Pradesh is the first state who came forward to undertake online training and his teachers. So I think big round of applause for Andhra Pradesh states as well. I've got two personalities with me to introduce, and they are the big one. And then I'll let you know then after the topic what we are going to discuss now under the NISTA. The first expert I would like to welcome, Professor Anupam Ahuja, expert who has worked to promote inclusive education. I welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you for the
and welcome. With her, there is another one that's also a big one, you can see. Professor Ranjan Arora, in charge curriculum group. I welcome you, ma'am, also.
Good evening. Good evening.
Now, both have been introduced. Now, tell you the topic what we are going to discuss. Actually, not me, these both, the, you know, the big ones will let you know about what exactly about the NISTA, what initiative we have, has been taken, and what extra we are going to do now as per the online mode. Well, the topic we have, that is curriculum and inclusive classroom. Now, that is the interesting thing, that during the COVID-19 situation, what extra we are going to provide to the teachers now, not to the students. So I think they are the best one who will let us know about this. So I will start first with you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Dharminder ji. Anupam ji, are you reading textbook?
Oh, yes. Dharminder ji gave this introduction, and I was reading this very interesting paragraph, and I just went back to it. I'm sorry. But you know, when I was reading this textbook, which is something I really like doing, friends, reading is something that comes to me naturally. But today, Ranjana ji, I was thinking, when we give this, teachers get a textbook like this in their hands, what must they be thinking? I mean, where does this textbook come from? Who wrote it? Is it just randomly put together a few pages and given? Obviously not. But I think this is something that I was thinking about. Maybe some teachers may also be thinking about this very question. Would you like to say something about this?
Yes, Anupam ji, first of all, this is very, very nice curiosity that you have placed before us. And it is really high time for our teachers to know about the very mechanisms, the very process of developing this textbook. This textbook is not developed in isolation with some organized kind of process. Yeah. There is a process, and for taking this textbook and reading this textbook, first of all, we should go back to our national education policy.
Yeah. Oh, it takes us to
yes.
The
there is a whole process. Hmm. National education policy gives us guidelines for the development of national curriculum framework.
Yes, indeed.
And after
does.
And when we develop national curriculum framework, after that, this national curriculum framework, we develop syllabus. Mm. And after this syllabus, we develop textbooks. Uh-huh. And then teachers use these textbooks for the transacting in the classroom.
Oh,
so there is whole linkages between this policy and curriculum framework, syllabus, and textbook. Mm. And as you know, now this new national education policy 2020
yes.
is in place,
yes.
and it is really giving many recommendations about curriculum.
Yeah.
And it is also saying that we should have contextualized textbooks that to be developed by the states.
Mm. But this must be a difficult task to make it contextualized. Who will do it? I'm sure it is not the states cannot make contextualized textbooks for the entire country. Right?
Of course, you are very right. Yes, there are common core. in values. Our policy.
Yes.
Our policy always gives some common core like sensitivity towards environment, scientific temper, you can say, constitutional values. Culture, our culture, linguistic diversity. So those kinds of things, when common core comes, this national curriculum framework gives guidelines on this common core. Okay, we have to
follow this.
We have to follow this and in this way. Now, and NCERT develops model syllabus and textbooks. And this model syllabus and textbooks is the base for the states. Then states take this model syllabus and textbooks and develop their own textbooks, contextualizing. Now, suppose we have struggle for freedom in our as a common core in our policy. But now at the national level, we can give elaboration about national level warriors and heroes. But when it comes to state, they
I
have to include their own heroes, their own state warriors.
Because so the children must have heard from their elders about the local heroes.
Yes.
And that is what you're saying, the state then looks into the making them connect.
Yes. And when we come to curriculum, of course, they will also ask that, okay, we have given national curriculum framework. Okay, this is the national curriculum framework. Okay, after this policy now, new policy,
we will make
new national curriculum framework very soon. But this is the national curriculum framework 2005. And you see, and based on this national curriculum framework,
we have
come out with the syllabus. These are the syllabus. This is elementary stage syllabus. And after this syllabus, we have come out with these kinds of textbooks. So now, many must be having this question, then where is this curriculum? What is this curriculum?
And all day in a school, we just keep, you know, if you listen to a teacher, she says, no, today I have to cover this part of the curriculum. You know, I am lagging behind. My teacher next door is raced. Dharminderji, you must have also heard teachers struggling, you know, and trying to compete with other each other to cover this the curriculum.
Right.
Of course. And you see, this curriculum is entirely school-based.
Yes.
When we give this guideline as a national curriculum framework, you have syllabus, you have now textbook. Now school has to design its own curriculum. That okay, what should go into the morning assembly, and what should be our timetable. And we all have gone through the school education. We know that there are annual activities, there are assessment days. So those kinds of things come under this curriculum.
So that's very interesting. You have made this so simple for teachers to understand. Well, actually, teachers, all this that we both have just shared, we have put it together for you in module one. You know, and making it very simple for you to understand how to transact a curriculum, right? And how to find, as a teacher, flexibility that is lying in this curriculum. You often also talk about a hidden curriculum, Ranjana ji. What is that?
Is that mystery? I'm also coming in that question.
First time, right? Curriculum. Do we hide something? No, no, no.
No, it's not, it's not that mean.
Ranjana ji, why don't you also uncover this aspect for the teachers? What do we mean when we're talking about a hidden curriculum?
Yes, this is also one of the favorite questions of mine. Hidden curriculum. Now, Anupam ji, we have given this gender parity, or we should be gender sensitive.
Yes, our framework.
In our module, is also saying,
framework,
is also saying. But what is happening now in the school? Now, teacher is giving a certain kind of task to girls and certain kind of task to boys. And also saying that, okay, the boys are boys should be sitting in different rows and girls should be sitting in the different rows. Now,
curriculum framework
is not saying this, and even textbooks also illustrations are not given in that manner.
In fact, they say the contrary to what you're
But in the classroom, the child is looking at the rows, at the sitting situation, and also seeing that okay, teacher is asking girls to bring the glass of water, but teacher is asking me to go into the market and purchase something, or go to the other teachers to bring chalk or something like that. So they differentiate these kinds of roles and work, and also of course they have their homes also there. Yes. Also and sometimes parents also do like this kind of thing,
and therefore so they tell their sisters also to do these things for
yes.
them.
So this is called hidden curriculum, yeah. which children imbibe, if not directly take, yes. but they really absorb those
and
kinds
this
of
makes
things.
Discrimination very yes. obvious also.
Very obvious, yes. very yes. obvious. And and now we have covered this curriculum, national yeah. curriculum framework, syllabus,
and
textbooks, and also now there is one term, teacher support material.
Oh, exactly.
Like what you told just
yes.
now,
yes,
that
yes.
we have included all these things in the module. Hmm. So these kinds of modules
yes.
and training packages are teacher support material.
Yes, and they need it. They
yes.
really need it.
And this
because we bring up examination changes, you know, certain course, procedural
yes,
changes.
Yes.
Now, how does a teacher know that? She can't go to the national curriculum framework
yes.
to know this.
Yes.
So is that where the teachers we use these teacher material for such topics?
Of course, we
yes.
have developed these kinds of packages,
hmm.
assessment source book,
yes,
continuous and comprehensive evaluation packages
teachers, yeah.
to help teachers
understand these
yes.
current issues. And I think they are very helpful for teachers.
Yes.
Because they tend to then be able to read it to themselves,
yes.
make and according to the problems that they are, challenges they are facing,
yes.
they find answers.
Mm. Of course. Mm. And they really bring their attitudinal changes also.
Yes.
Because
yes.
these really help a lot.
Yes.
Now, giving you one example of this, when we were doing face-to-face Nishtha,
yes.
as Dharmendraji has already said that we have already trained 17.5 lakh
teachers
under this. So, when we were doing face-to-face Nishtha, there was a teacher
mm-hmm.
In yes. some of the session, and he came to the stage and said, I want to share one experience, one of my experience. We were talking about inclusive education.
Oh,
so I would like you to explain that. So when that teacher came to us, he said ki earlier when I was in some school, I was not comfortable dealing with children with special needs.
Yes, and in fact not only him. Many teachers think that it is extra work.
Yes.
Why bring these children? Why don't we allow them to go to other schools?
Yes.
Let them study with teachers who know how to teach them. Why are they in our classrooms?
Exactly. He said like this, that he was thinking in this way only.
Yes.
So he was having a child with hearing impairment in his class.
Hmm.
And that child used to come to him, but he used to ignore that child because he was thinking in the way that you just said. So one day that child came to this teacher and tried to make him understand or explain like this. He was
constantly acting like this.
So twice, but that teacher could not understand and later on he got irritated and slapped that child. So that child really wept and when his mother came, that child went with his mother. His mother used to come every day and hand over that child
to the teacher and
saying that, no, it's you, up to you, how you will deal with my child.
To take that responsibility.
The second day also when this mother came and she handed over that child to the teacher, this teacher said, I remember yesterday he wanted to say something to me, but I could not understand. So what was that? Then that mother explained, yesterday was his birthday.
And he was talking about the
cake. He was inviting you to come to his house
to
cut the cake. But when you snap, he didn't eat anything at night and he didn't celebrate his birthday. So I just wanted to ask you, Anupamji, that how can we make our teachers sensitive about these kinds of things, and what teachers should play this kind of role?
I mean, this is a very fundamental question, and that is the reason Ranjanaji and I have put this in the very first module. You know, we both have worked together to build this model for you. We want you right at the outset not to think of only a few children who are doing well and who are able to communicate to you, but to also think about this child who has his own ways of communicating.
Mm-hmm.
He's also trying to communicate, but he's communicating in his own style. Now, that style that he is using is not his fault. it is our need that we should understand the way he is communicating.
Yes.
That is what is the cornerstone of inclusion, to be able to change ourselves in order to accommodate the needs of these children. That's what we are trying to tell each one of us. You tell me, I tell you, Dharmendraji tells yet another, that now our policies, our legal acts are all very clear and say in one voice that every child has the right to be in your classroom, and we must know how to teach these children. So where this child has the same right to be in the class as the child with who has good hearing. So they all need to study together in your classroom. Now this module, right in the beginning, all these years in our country, we have worked very hard to bring education to where it is.
Correct.
But still we want to push this idea. As you said, it's the attitude, it's the belief that every child can learn. We must know how to teach the children.
True.
And if a child is lagging behind, it's not the fault of the child. If I'm born without good sight, it's not my fault. I also have to be given equal opportunity in the regular classroom to be able to learn with others. Now, you may wonder, why this? I mean, after all, why not send them to separate schools? Just like we are saying just now, when children finish school, they come into your and my common society. We don't have separate societies for these children. We live all together. So classrooms should reflect society. Classrooms should be what society we want to see. In our society, we want to see all differences being accommodated in a natural way.
True.
Everybody has a potential.
Yes.
Everybody has a strength. Today, if I did not bring my glasses, reading glasses, I am not a normal professional today in my workplace in NCRT, because I cannot read. So who is normal and who is not normal is simply based on this, the reading glasses.
Mm-hmm.
So I could be normal today, but tomorrow I may not be, or in an hour, if God forbid there's an earthquake, we all can become disabled also.
Nobody knows what will
nobody
happen.
Nobody knows what. So every child should be seen with the same lens by a teacher. That's what we need to work. And I think that's what we've always been trying to say, both of us together in our module. Friends, let's think together. How can we make this possible? How do we make every child feel wanted and happy in our classrooms? We have brought many things for you in this module to make you understand these aspects.
Mm-hmm. So, very nicely placed, Anupamji. And when that the teacher, when this the mother said like this, suddenly teacher found
that
something, something he has learned the lesson that day, and then he immediately went to learn sign language.
Yes.
And after learning that language, now he is very popular among teacher fraternity and slum area school, where he used to go and give help children who are with hearing impairment to understand whatever. So
he is a model for everybody.
Yes,
what you have said is a very profound truth. Nowadays we are saying, just like we learn Sanskrit, we learn French, we learn German, we should all, what you have just said, learn how to sign.
Yes,
because if I learn how to sign, I can communicate with a child and an adult who cannot speak language like you and I are talking. So I would, and Ranjana ji, together with Dharmendra ji, who is being with us in this communication to you, we want to urge you to think about this. How do we accommodate the differences by taking steps, maybe a small step, like being inquisitive about sign language, being
course,
inquisitive about Braille.
Right. I have a small question while you were explaining this, because the thing is that somewhere teachers think that the mentality of a particular child or the children who would like to study in a, you know, in a, immersive college or school, But somewhere you understand that that child should be educated, but somewhere you are bounded but not able to study them, not able to teach them.
Yes.
So what will happen as per the mentality of a teacher?
Yes, indeed. A teacher does feel lost, Dharmendraji, and does feel lonely. And sometimes lots of effort that she puts in, still she doesn't see result. And that disheartens her further when she's working.
Yeah, that's what I raised this question, because you are the teacher.
Absolutely right you are. Now, that's what this module is really telling you. How do we build our strength bit by bit?
Hmm.
The other very important thing is, when she builds her strength like this, bit by bit, why are we talking about inclusion is also because she becomes a good teacher, a better teacher, when she learns how to build her strength for catering to differences. And let me tell you another very profound truth. Research the world over. Ranjana ji, remember we were reading that entire volume and trying to collate.
Yes.
Research the world over says that when there are classes with heterogeneous learning styles of children, the achievement of every child improves.
True.
So that is the reason in this module we have asked you to think about transacting the curriculum along with practicing the inclusive pedagogy.
See, the live questions came out. I would like to tell you, ma'am.
Yes.
That is Sheikh Shahnawaz. He says, he's asking is, what is the question is, do we need resources rooms in our Indian school setup?
Yes, that's a very good question. First and foremost, my friend, you are the biggest resource. Remember that a teacher knows it all.
Hmm.
She has to discover whether you have a resource room, and if you don't think that the world is going to give you everything and only then you will start.
Hmm.
Start with what you have.
Yes.
Use your abilities as a teacher. If you have a resource room, it's very good, because that will give you the teaching aids, and as Ranjanaji said, also teacher guides that will be available and tips for you to handle the child.
Correct.
But in our country, it's diverse. Some districts in Andhra Pradesh will have a few resource rooms. There could be rural areas where may not have these resource rooms.
I think this is the big question, especially into the urban areas, that you don't have facility to provide these kind of things.
Yes.
So where the students can be, you know, beneficial.
Yes.
What should we do to provide them these kind of facilities so they can enhance their skills?
Yes. One of the easiest ways is to invent your own resource material.
Hmm.
You know, I know my child, I know his learning lag, I know what helps him read better. So why don't I devise something that's out of no-cost material that's lying around, and work with the child to construct an aid? It may take time, but it will be very useful for a teacher to discover what teaching aid helps a child to learn better. And that discovery of making something small which helps. Suppose I was just to take this sheet of paper and I know that a child cannot read this title. Okay? I just cut a window on this page from here. Now that helps, that window helps the child learn, read the line. This is a teaching aid as well. If I just cut a window and place it on the book, and then I can read our past. He may not be able to read without this. So simple, you know, acts like this can also make teaching aids for a child teacher. And that's what we always want to encourage you to innovate, to be creative, to think how we can devise certain simple interventions when there are no resource rooms, there are no formal teaching aids to help all children learn. Other children can also work to make these teaching aids for each other. What we are trying to say is that we are all in it together. Once you create that culture, learning will happen
for
all children.
So they need to create by their own.
Yes, they should encourage.
And even there, I think there are some organizations, some institutions in their neighborhood. They have to explore. So not only they have to create, but they have to explore also.
And give what they have explained. They have made, they can share with the institutions, as she says, and they can get. So they should not feel alone. What we both are trying to tell you is that we must search for solutions.
Hmm.
And some references I think we have given this module.
Yes.
So that they can explore those kinds of institutions and ask these kinds of aids.
Yes.
Sometimes these institutions give these kinds of
free
is free of cost.
Free of cost.
So that we need to explore.
Yes. See, the audience are taking this session is very interestingly. And one more question I've got for you, especially I would like to ask this from Professor Ranjana Arora. And what question is the question is what is the natural resources learning from children in their surroundings, which is the best one to learn joyfully? I think this is the best question.
So
joyfully, there is joy.
And that
depends a lot where we are going to take it.
Yes, and
it?
I think more than us teachers know
how to
link school knowledge with life outside the school.
Yes.
So we have to bring children experience in the classroom.
Correct.
And of course, if you see food is a theme in our science and in our environmental studies.
Yes.
And there are lots of food in the vicinity, in the neighborhood, and they can start what food the children eat.
Yes.
From that they can start even not only the face-to-face class but also online classes.
Yes.
Nowadays, which we are ever going.
Yes.
Plants are all together. Vehicles, transport, medium of transport, work we do. We have lots of people. Some people are doing car painting. Some people are doing
a tailor job. Yeah.
So those kinds of things are really, we have to just look. Create or develop skill of observation in our students.
Yes.
So that they can link whatever they observe in the neighborhood with the school knowledge which we are providing.
And how to create a sensitivity towards difference also.
Yes.
Even when we are discussing jobs, we can also make children feel that there is no job that's a small job.
Yeah.
And no parent, maybe he may be earning less, but it's an important contribution he is making. That's how we will be able to divide these divides between the rich, the low middle and the, you know, considered low jobs can be wiped out. So your role and this question that you have asked shows that you are very keen to take forward, the inclusive culture in society.
Bhavani Dodda is the man who asked this question. I think you must have got the answer as well.
And it's a good question.
There is one more question. It is from my side actually.
Oh, okay.
I would like to differentiate now because why? Sometimes it happens. I'm talking about the education system, especially once you go through with you are going to deal with the urban education system, and if you are going to differentiate the rural education system, right? Somewhere you are getting facilities at a time, there is no problem at all, and somewhere you are not getting those things which is very essential as per the education in a point of view. So somewhere that is the notion of very common people, they must have asked this, that there is some problem with the education system. Is it good or is it bad, and that should not like this? I mean, if you both can elaborate this a bit.
Whether the system is good or bad.
Yeah, somewhere they blame that the resource is not coming on time to us. That means the government is not doing all these things. You must be aware about this.
Yes, it's good to be doing this catharsis sometimes. As an educator, I think we're all teachers, and teaching is a tough job. Teaching is very time consuming, and if you're doing it well, it consumes you. So sometimes, Dharmendraji, it's good to give vent to your feelings, and that helps you also understand that some of the things that I've said are not really important. I just said what I wanted to say. I wanted it out of my system, and now that it's out, I join the class with fresh energy again.
Correct.
But if you don't allow teachers to de-stress and to say what they want to, sometimes when we put on a soda bottle a cap and we try to fit in, it suddenly still shoots up. That should be avoided. That, as an educationist, I will always say, don't allow that cap to fly off. Give vent to your thoughts. Discuss them. We are all in a profession together. We all want all children to learn and be happy in school. That's our objective. We don't want to fill pots. We want to ignite their minds. We want them to be creative. We want them to be always learning and coming to us with a stride in their walk. They should want to come to school. Now, to do that, we have to work very hard. And when we work very hard, we have our pressures. Friends, as teachers, both Professor Ranjana and I are of the view, do not put a cap on the soda bottle. Let your feelings go free.
I got your point now.
And then let teachers, discuss amongst themselves how to solve them. We do that even in NCRT a lot.
That means there is no need to, you know, expect the results in a quick succession.
No,
you
exactly.
need to have some patience.
Yes.
And moreover, sometimes I feel that differences are in our mind.
Yes.
Not, exactly. Not even in the field.
Yeah.
Because you see, when we talk about like teaching it, one day one teacher asked me that I don't have teaching it, how to teach my children. I told ki what teaching it you need. Even your simple question can be a teaching aid. Now, I just want to ask you people, if answer is 5, what be the question? So now, Dharmendra, you tell me. If answer is 5, what is the question? You tell me any question.
It could be any kind of, you know, question form could be anything.
What?
Like, what comes before 5, then 4, and then 5. If before comes, that is 4.
Okay, no. What comes after 4?
Then your, 5 your, less,
your, obviously. Your question will be, what's come after 4?
You have modified my question, actually.
And, suppose I was saying that I had 6 toffees, you took 1. How many were left?
Yes.
Okay.
So, now, this is the simple answer that if answer is 5, what would be the question? Suppose if a teacher throws this answer in the classroom, 30 students will be giving the questions.
Yes.
And these questions may be from science, that they will be saying that how many sense organs are there?
Yes.
So, answer is 5. How many pandavas are there? Answer is 5. How many fingers in one hand is there?
5.
Answer is 5.
Yeah.
So, you see, with using this kind of teaching aid, that answer is 5, what would be the question? You will be having on your chart 30 to 35 questions. So, you have generated content.
And you have generated thinking minds.
Thinking minds. Okay. Then, if you come to this room, even in the classroom, the pedagogy of space, we have windows, we have doors. You see, suppose in urban area, teacher may be taking posters in the classroom, taking charts in the classroom. But in rural area, if these things are not available, teacher can use his or her own gestures, postures, even this rumal. Rumal can be used as an
teaching
aid. As a teaching aid. Now one can see that what kind of things we can do from this rumal. So we can clean our face. We can make something
on the head.
So these kinds of
gear.
Things.
You can use as a mask as well.
You can use it as
a
mask.
As a mask as well nowadays.
Yes.
So there are n number of things which teacher can do without any hard and fast teaching aid.
Yes.
Only his gesture, posters, stories
can give you.
Now I would request Anupam ji for one story which I like when Anupam ji that how can we make everyone very meaningful and useful and that pot story.
Oh, you want
that
me
you
to
used
talk.
To yeah.
Okay,
so
right.
You used to tell us.
Yes. Well, it you can see that Ranjana ji and I have spent decades together. You know, we have lived as educationists together, and because of this, we remember each other's anecdotes and stories. Well, this story goes like this, friends, and it is an inspiring story. Once, like all stories, one morning, you know, there was a pot bearer. He was carrying 2 pots of water on a cane, and he was taking them up a hill. And as he was filling his pots with water, he realized that one of the pots has got looks very sad. Now, since it's a story, a pot can look sad, you know. And he was a good water bearer, and he did not want to see sad faces. Just like you teachers and I, we don't like to see sad faces. So he asked his pot, "Why are you sad?" He said, "Well, you know why I'm sad. You know, this other pot teases me every day. I ignore what he says. But today, what he has said has made me really feel useless and worthless. And that is the reason I wish I would break and you would not have to carry me every day." Now, the pot bearer smiled and said, "Oh, he's telling you that you have holes in your the bottom, there are some holes which are becoming bigger. And that is what he's teasing you about." So he said, "Yes. And now don't try to lift my mood. You know, I am soon going to break probably." The pot bearer was a calm teacher like you, a calm personality. He said, "Today I'm going to tell you something. Do what I say. When we come down from the hilltop, after giving our two pots, you will see that you are going to be happy. So as we go up, you see, observe the path.
Correct.
Okay. So the pot that was having holes and had leakage of water, observe the path. When they came down, he said, I noticed that on my side of the hill, there were very nice flowers that were blooming, and on the other side, the pot which was very nicely made, there was nothing. It was barren ground. So the pot bearer said, you're right, your observation is right. You see, I knew about your weaknesses. I knew that there were holes. I thought of bringing some seeds and I put them in the on the path where we were going up, and I knew that as water drops, some water will, you will naturally water the seeds, and therefore, you see, the writer with whom we give these pots to waits for me to come up, because I pick some flowers that fall, that are bloomed, you know, when they bloom. So he waits, he puts them on his table and then starts writing his story. So in a way, you are more useful than the full pot. And that is what I, knowing your weaknesses, I had decided that I will not make it a weakness, but I'll make it a strength. That is something I think the water bearer has given us a message. And thank you, Ranjana ji, for reminding me of this story, because this gives a message to all of us. And our module, friends, is full of such stories, is full of such anecdotes which stay in your mind. You know, this story, I'm sure you will not forget. There are similar stories which Ranjana ji and I have put together in this module. There are video programs which will explain the concept of curriculum, inclusion. There are other very interesting things. We will not tell you everything. Explore this module. Yes. Go through it and ask us questions. Yes. And we will be very happy as a team to come back.
And
to
why I asked Anupam ji to tell this story, because storytelling is also a resource.
I need to say something. I was assuming before why you are giving all the correct answer, because you have got complete library with you. You can see 5 or 6, 7 here with you. These are the modules. But in fact, on the top notch, you are an amazing storyteller as well.
Okay. Because as Ranjana ji said, story is also a resource.
Correct.
Yes. And that is also
irrespective of urban and rural. Every teacher knows
it doesn't cost any money.
Yes.
See, one more comment I've got. Actually, it's not a question. I just need to mention this thing, whether you both are going to agree this or not. VKS, I think this is the name or no. Please make the complete name when you are asking something. Resources room are necessary, but not always. And then after, the students in the classroom themselves are resources.
Excellent.
Teachers, TLM services, knowledge, information, internet resources in our surrounds, and so on.
Oh, very nice. Good. Whatever we said,
you have imbibed it and given it back to us.
Very nice.
We are sure that this training program online, you're going to enjoy it immensely. The questions that you have given us is an indication. So we both are going as very satisfied academics, having launched module one online with a group of excellent teachers. We can see the fire in you to learn and to grow. And remember, NCERT is always ready to hold your hand and take you forward as you take small steps and big leaps to take forward this agenda of teaching all children in your classroom.
Yes. So now coming to one more concept,
please.
Learning outcomes.
Oh yes, we forgot so, that.
So we
that's the final one.
So that's the whole time is yours. So I'm not asking anything.
So
I haven't given any clue yet.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the document which is a learning outcome document.
When we assess.
And and as we can see that when we were interacting with you, there is one observation came that students, teachers are themselves resources for teaching learning. So I think this is one of the learning outcome of this interactive session. One can see these kinds of learning outcomes when we teach children, when children learn, they also show some changes in their competencies, their skills, their behavior, and that we term as learning outcomes.
There is one more thing I would like to tell you that you know that will brought the smile on your face again. Kuma Vijay is the guy or girl, I don't know. Excellent examples to utilize even the weakness to success.
Very good.
No, the way you are explaining all the things to them. That's why
and they are choosing the right words.
So now this is also one of the, when they understand things and then they link, they reflect. So that is also one of the learning outcomes. So these kinds of learning outcomes we have given in this learning outcome document, which is also whatever resources we are showing here, those all resources are available on our website. So you will be getting all the resources with you. So now this learning outcomes, so class wise learning outcomes we have given, whenever you teach your textbooks, your through your TLM, but you must ensure that class-wise, subject-wise learning outcomes children are attaining, so that there should not be any gap in their learnings. So when we know that you are state resource group members and you have to mentor your teachers. So when you go to your teachers, when your teachers ask some support from you, so you have to mention or you have to refer all these material, all these things to teachers, and also making them understand how can they use these resources and these material for the improvement in the classroom processes.
And so without creating any stress in the classroom.
Yes.
We have worked on these learning outcomes, which we have just shown you, with this emphasis that we look at every child's progress. He or she is making. We don't compare children.
And
we don't do an annual exam at the fag end in which a child collapses, and does not perform sometimes well.
Yes.
These learning outcomes are for you to see. And as we are telling you, we have worked relentlessly to create a lot of resources for you. Please do refer to them. But remember that you yourself are the biggest resource.
There you are. I think that's why I told you you're the amazing teacher. You should not be a teacher, you should be a musician, I think I would say. See, we have a few minutes left before you tell something, ma'am. I have a question for you, actually, to Ranjan Arora, ma'am. And what the question is, and that is from the Sheila Saidulu. What she is saying, how to coordinate the pace of the learning of the normal people send challenged ones, I think. Something, how to coordinate the pace of the learning. The people who are suffering with the pace of the learn. So how could you make it simple?
So Vaise, this is very good question, and this question must be addressed by Professor Anupam Ahuja. But I just want to say this thing, that when you provide opportunities in the classroom, when you create situation in the classroom and provide each learner opportunities to construct knowledge,
to share
their experiences, and to come out with their own opinions, own views, then I think you address each and every child's need. But of course, technically, what is important and what need to be done, I think Professor Anupam Ahuja will be explaining.
I think most of us, you've said it, Ranjana ji, very well. What is important for each one of us to remember is, don't set a pace. Once you fix a pace, you see who is going slow, who is going fast. It is each child's movement from where he is. We all have to do a certain curriculum given to us. We have to cover it fine, but life is not just the 11 months for the child. A child is, you and I are still learning, right? We are lifelong learners. So if a child is going slow for some period, let the child be.
Correct.
That's what learning outcomes also focus on. That's what our pedagogy also talks about. Find out why the child is learning slowly. Find out how you can teach better so that his pace gradually improves. That's what we will always tell you. Do not mystify increasing the pace, taking him to tuition, taking him to X person to, find out what his problem is. Don't make the problem look big. Make the child naturally learn, and he or she will catch up. Life is long, and pace is not something, he is not a machine who has to be, evaluated at a certain.
And I must inform you that Anupam ji has given very good story animal school in this module. Yes. And when you will read the story, you will find your answer.
Yes.
I think we all would like love to listen this story, but the time is very less now. We have got only 1.5 minutes. So I just need to conclude this thing. Then in the beginning, I have told you that this is the first module as we are going to start it up as the online mode. And the Andhra Pradesh is the first ever state, I would say,
yes,
if I'm not wrong, who came
yeah.
forward to undertake online training and the teacher. So any message you would like to give to the Andhra Pradesh citizens or the citizens for India as well, I think?
We just want to say that we have worked very hard to yes. bring out these kinds of modules. The entire team, NCRT and the CIT people are there to make this program more and more interactive, to answer your curiosities, your questions. So we just expect from your side that, like, we want to mentor you and we are mentoring you. You please mentor your teachers
yes.
and go up to their classroom to see that whether changes are happening or not, children are achieving learning outcomes which we are expected to achieve.
Yes.
So
and
this is our
message. And yeah. finally, we will also say, please clap for yourself, because you are the first state that has taken up
we
the online
class. Yeah.
You please clap for yourself, and
we will also
join
yes.
in clapping for you
yes.
to take this. We will learn from you how yeah. to conduct our next online in another state.
Yes.
Do give us our feedback, and remember, as we have just said together, each child's learning is important for you.
Yes.
Monitor your own teaching methodology and ensure that every child comes to your school and wants to come and does not want to leave your school. Happy teaching and happy learning for your children. Thank you.
There you are. That was the first module of NISTA, all about, as we have learned a lot. And I think we would have a lot more after this. The next session would definitely be come out after 2 or 3 weeks or hours or so, or I think in the next weeks as well. So please learn these things simply, whatever you have conveyed this to our audiences, students, so they can, use their resources, they can be skillful, they can be knowledgeable, and so many other things. So thank you so much for watching this program, the Andhra states and the India state. India is almost country. So thank you so much for watching this program, and we have no more time now. So thank you so much.
I think repeat will come tomorrow.
Yes, we can tell them.
I think the repeat telecast will definitely come tomorrow. So if those guys who haven't tuned yet to watch this NISTA program, that will be repeated once again. So you can watch this NISTA session where with these, the extraordinary teachers. So where I would say they are the professor, not the professor. I would say they are the god of the teacher who conveyed their message to you. So you can watch this program again, and that would be a repeat telecast if you missed this session. So thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
For being with us and provide us a great kind of knowledge. And thank you so much for you all people watching this program, and stay tuned with the Kishore Manch Swayamprabha channel number 31. Thank you.
Thank you.